Can you monitor a couple of minutes? The transmission is tab. Okay, you're watching. Okay. So inshallah, we will go and start. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. This is Evergreen Islamic Center. And tonight we will be doing tafsir, brief tafsir of juz number 9 of Al-Quran. The name of the juz is Qala al-Mala'u al-Ladina, and the ayat number of Surah Al-A'raf at this point is ayat number 88. We are in Surah Al-A'raf. Briefly, before I start from this point, I want to go back and explain what Al-A'raf is. The surah, in the surah, the meaning of the word Al-A'raf is a higher ground. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning in this surah a scene of the day of judgment. And in that scene, some people are saying something. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran is quoting their statement. So this is in the, starting from ayat number 44 up to ayat number 49. Of Surah Al-A'raf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning that on the day of judgment, all the people will be raised and brought in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the judgment. The judgment will start and people will be divided according to their worldly deeds into the people who will be going to paradise or those who will be going to the hellfire. But the time is when both the groups are still present in the day of judgment before entering the Jahannam and the Jannat. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Vanada, at that time, the recognition from the face will be that some faces will be shiny and bright, and those will be the people who will be going to paradise. On the other hand, some faces will be dark, and those faces will be the faces of the people who have been marked to go to Jahannam. So even on the day of judgment, people can be recognized by looking at their faces. So there will be some people who will have the bright faces. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling them Ashabul Jannah. They are not in the Jannat yet. There will be other group of the people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is titling them Ashabun Nar. They are still not in the fire. So anybody outside can recognize. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that the conversation will take place. Wanada ashabul jannati ashaban nar. The people of the ashabul jannah, the people of the jannah will call the people who will be marked to go to the hellfire. They will say, an qad wajadna ma wa'adana rabbuna. What our Lord had promised us in the life when we were living on the earth, we have found today that is true. Haqqa, the truth. Fahal wajadtum, and they will ask, have you also found what Allah promised you, that if you disobey, what will be your reward and punishment? So they will say, haqqa, they will reply, yes, we also found. Qalu na'am, we found it true. Fa'azzana mu'azzinun bainahum. Then a caller will call in between these two groups by saying, La'anatullahi ala zalimin. The curse of Allah is upon those who are the wrongdoers. Then what the third situation Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning is that there will be some people who are standing on a higher ground. And that is the meaning of the Al-A'raf. Al-A'raf means some higher place. And these are the people whose case has not been judged yet. They are waiting to find out where their destination is going to be. So Allah says, وَبَيْنَهُمَا حِجَابٌ, and between these two groups, there will be a curtain. وَعَلَى الْعَرَافِ رِجَالٌ, and on the Araf, on the higher ground, there will be some men who will be standing. يَعْرِفُونَ, they will recognize. كُلَّمْ بِسِيمَاهُمْ, everyone who will be standing there by their faces, if these people will go to Jahannam or Jannat. So first they will look at the people who have been dedicated to or decided to go to the Jannat. They will say, Wanada was Habal Jannati and Salamun Alaikum. They will, these people on the Araf will say to the people of Ashabul Jannah, Salamun Alaikum, Lam Yadkhuluha Wahum Yatmaun. These people have not entered the paradise, but they are expecting. Waida Surifat Absaruhum Tilqa Ashabin Nar. When their eyes will turn towards the people who have been destined to go to the Jahannam, they will say, O Allah, Qalu Rabbana, O our Lord, La taj'alna ma'al qawmiz zalimeen. Do not make us among those people who are the wrongdoers. So the conversation continues, but this is the highlight of the place of Al-Araf. Now, inshallah, we will go to the beginning of the juz number 9. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Qala al-malau alladhina istakbaru min qawmihi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is this still Surah Al-Araf, ayat number 88, juz number 9 is starting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, is telling us a story which took place in the past with the Prophet Shu'aib. Shu'aib alayhi salam was sent to the people of Midian, and he invited people towards the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but the leaders of the town stood against him. Qala al-mala'u allazina nastakbaru. Allah says, those people among the leaders who did takabbur min qawmihi, from his people, what did they say? La nukhrijannaka ya Shu'aibu. O Shu'aib, we will throw you out, we will expel you. Walladhina amanu ma'aka, and those people who have believed with you, min qaryatina, from our town. Aw la ta'udunna fi millatina, or you better turn back into our religion. Upon that, Shu'aib alayhi salam said, qala awala kunna karihin, even if we are completely hating what you are doing or disliking what you're doing. So the conversation continues between Shu'aib alayhi salam and the people of the town until the punishment and azab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in ayat number 91, فَأَخَذَتْهُمُ الرَّجْفَةُ. The earthquake seized them, took over them. فَأَصْبَحُوا فِي دَارِهِمْ جَاثِمِينَ. And they were laying in their houses dead, like they were on their knees. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Shu'aib alayhi salam, after the azab had come and Allah had saved him and those people who believed, he turned to these people, fatawalla anhum. He turned toward these people even though they were dead. Waqala, and he said, Shu'aib said, ya qawmi, O my people, laqad ablaghtukum risalati rabbi, I have definitely conveyed to you the messages that my Lord sent to me. وَنَصَحْتُ لَكُمْ, and I had advised you. فَكَيْفَ عَسَىٰ عَلَىٰ قَوْمٍ كَافْرِينَ. So how can I be sorrowful about those people who rejected and did the kufr? Then we will continue in this surah. There is a very long description about the incidents that took place between Musa alayhi salam and Fir'aun. And that story starts from ayat number 103 of Surah Al-Araf. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I briefly go over some of the ayats, the highlight of these events that took place between Musa alayhi salam and Fir'aun. The ayat number 104 say, waqala Musa ya Fir'aun, Musa alayhi salam said, O Fir'aun, inni rasulum min rabbil alameen, indeed, I am a messenger from the Lord of the worlds. Haqiqun ala Allah, aqulu ala Allah. It is the fact, it's the truth which I say regarding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Illa al-haq, it is nothing but the truth. Qad jaitakum bi bayyinatin min rabbikum. So the truth and the clear signs have come from your Lord. Fa'arsil ma'iya bani Israel. So send Bani Israel, free them and send with me. So the argument continues between Musa alayhi salam and Fir'aun wants to see if he has any signs or miracles. So Musa alayhi salam in ayat number 107 showed him, فَأَلْقَى عَصَاهُ فَإِذَا هِيَ سُعْبَانٌ مُبِينٌ. He threw down his asa, his staff, and it became a serpent. Clear. وَنَزَعَ يَدَهُ فَإِذَا هِيَ بَيْضَاءُ لِلنَّاظِرِينَ. And he pulled his hand out of his underarm, and it became a white shining hand for the people who were seeing. Upon them, Pharaoh says that this is a sahir. This person is a magician. So he invited other magicians, and they had a competition where the magicians threw their ropes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we continue that when the magicians came, ayat number 116, they said to Musa alayhi salam, do you want to start or we shall start? Qala alqu, Musa alayhi salam said, no, you go ahead and start. Falamma alqaw saharu ayunan nas. It's a very strange thing. Like today we call something hypnosis. Quran says that they threw their ropes on the ground, and they trapped the eyes and the vision of the people who were watching those ropes, and to the people they looked like these were snakes. So it is basically the similar technology that we call hypnosis nowadays. Magicians knew that, Allah alam, but they were still ropes. They did not turn into the snakes, but the people who were watching, they were thinking in their minds, they were looking like ropes. Even Musa alayhi salam saw those ropes turn into looking like the snakes. So he got fearful. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him that throw down your asa. And when he did that, his asa turned into a real snake. And he started swallowing these fake snakes, which were the ropes. So upon that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأُلْقِيَ السَّحَرَةُ سَاجِدِينَ. The magicians realized that this was not a game of magic, but this was the truth. So they fell down in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making sajda. And upon that, Pharaoh got more angry, and he says, I will kill you. And the story continues. It's several pages long, and most of the stories about them are known. So eventually, Pharaoh allowed Musa alayhi salam and his people to leave Egypt. As they were leaving, they had ocean in front of them. And Musa alayhi salam, by the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, threw his staff on the water. It is split into two sections. Musa alayhi salam and his people went through. Pharaoh followed through the same water, and water merged, combined. And Pharaoh and his army were drowned in front of everybody. So those are the stories. They continue. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also mentioning that when Bani Israel arrived in Palestine, they started disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They started asking that make an idol for us so we can worship. Then they made a calf. They started worshiping calf. Then they started giving Musa hard time. So that is a long story that goes on in this. Now, we will go to some other ayats. And we'll go to ayat number 204 of Surah Al-Araf. Some important ayats. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنْصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Very important words. Allah says, whenever Quran is being recited, fastamiu, listen with attention, not just listen, pay attention and listen to it, wa ansitu, and keep quiet, do not talk. That is the respect of the Quran. Unfortunately, in some countries, even in Middle East, those people who know Arabic language, they play the Quran in the restaurants, and people are chatting and talking and having good time, and Quran is being recited in the loudspeaker up there. Very disrespect of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forbidding that to do. Allah says, وَذْكُرْ رَبَّكَ فِي نَفْسِكَ, and remember your Lord in your heart. تَدَرُّعًا وَخِيفًا, with humility and quietly. وَدُونَ الْجَهْرِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ, and also loudly, بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآصَالِ, at the morning times and the night times, wala takum min al ghafilin, and do not be among those who are ignorant. Then we start Surah Al-Anfal. Surah Al-Anfal was revealed on the second Hijra, and this describes the description of the Battle of Badr. In the Battle of the Badr, first time Muslims were victorious. This was the first battle, basically. And they had possession of some Al-Anfal, which is the booty, Maal-e-Ghanima. And it was a question how to distribute that. So the surah starts with A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Ar-Rajim. Yas'alunaka anil anfal. They ask you, O Prophet, about the Maal-e-Ghanima, the booty of the war. Qulil anfalu lillahi wa rasul. Say the Al-Anfal belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger, and they are the one who are going to decide how to distribute. Fattaqullah, so fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa aslihu zata bainikum, and keep the relationship between yourself straight and correct. Maybe some of these things may cause a disagreement upon you. Watch it. Wa atiullaha wa rasulahu, and obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger. In kuntum mu'minin, if you are believer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala further says, innamal mu'minuna alladhina, indeed the believers are those, and we should look what Allah is saying next, that if we fall into the category, idha zukirallahu, when Allah's name is mentioned, wajilat qulubuhum, their heart starts trembling. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ, when the ayats, verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are recited upon them, زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا, their faith increases, وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ, and upon their Lord they do tawakkal and trust. We should check ourselves that when Allah's name is mentioned, what is the condition of our hearts? If nothing happened to our hearts, which means we actually are not being impacted by the zikr of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala further says, Alladhina yuqimuna salata, these are the people who establish the prayer. Wa mimma razaqnahum yunfiqoon, and of that what we give them, they spend. Ulaika humul mu'minuna haqqa, Allah says, these are truly those who are the believers. Lahum darajatun inda rabbihim, they have higher ranks and status with their Lord. Wa maghfiratun, and forgiveness. Wa rizqun kareem, and a noble provision. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this surah mentions many, many things that happened during the battle when it was taking place. Battle of Badr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, istastaghisuna rabbakum, before the battle you were asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you. فَاسْتَجَابَ لَكُمْ, so he responded, he heard you, he responded, and he said, أَنِّي مُمِدُّكُمْ بِأَلْفٍ مِّنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ مُرْدِفِينَ, I'm going to help you with 1,000 angels who will come and fight on your side, well prepared. And Allah says, this is just a news, good news, so people's hearts can be satisfied. تَطْمَئِنَّ بِهِ قُلُوبُكُمْ, وَمَنْ نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ, but the real help comes directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you are encountering the enemy in the battlefield. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the angels to do and go and help. He's saying, he commanded, إِذْ يُوْهِ رَبُّكَ, when your Lord revealed or inspired the angels or commanded the angels. Ilal malaikati, he said to the angels, anni ma'akum, I am with you, the angels. Fasabbitu alladhina amanu, so go and make the footsteps firm of those people who are fighting the battle. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his 313 companions were fighting in the battle of the Badr, first fight. Allah sent the angels to help, and Allah says, what I will do, سَأُلْقِي فِي قُلُوبِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الرُّعْبَ, I am going to put the fear in the hearts of those people who are doing a kufr here with Allah. فَضْرِبُوا فَوْقَ الْأَعْنَاقِ, so you angels go and strike their necks, hit them. Wadribu minhum kulla banan, and strike and hit on every fingers of these people who are fighting against the messenger and his companions. Then we'll do a couple more ayats because of the time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in ayat number 30 of Surah Al-Anfal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, he is addressing those who have believed in him, in tattaqullah, if you have taqwa, if you have fear, if you have consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is he going to do in response? Allah is promising, yaj'al lakum furqanan, he will make a criterion for you to separate right from wrong. Allah will make you see what is right and what is wrong, and he will make you distinguish between, wa yukaffir ankum sayyatikum, and he will remove from you your evil deeds, wa yaghfir lakum, and he will forgive you, wallahu dhul fadlil azim, Allah is great bounty, Allah is the giver of the great bounty. So inshallah we will maybe do one more ayat, is time for. So the next ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that wa idha tutla alayhim ayatuna, when our ayat, our verses are recited to these people, and these are the people kuffar of Makkah, or the people who are not believing in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, qalu, they say something, they say qad sami'na, yeah, we heard it, law nasha'u la qulna mithla haza, if we want we can bring this the verses similar to these verses of the Quran. They were big poets there, and they could claim that we can make up the verses and the statements and the things that Prophet is making up here. And they were calling his verses of the Quran as poetry also. So they are scholars, and they were poets and writers, and also they, we can do the same thing. Allah says, and they further said about the Quran, in hadha illa satirul awwalin, this is nothing but is the stories of the older people, older generation. This guy just tells us the stories, and that's what the Quran is. And then not only that, but they challenge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa idh qalu, and then when they said, Allahumma, they are calling Allah, O our Lord, in kana hadha huwal haqq, if this book or this Quran or this speech which this Prophet is reciting, mina indika, if it is in fact from you are sending, so show us. How do they want to see? Fa amtir alaina hijaratam minas samai, so send down upon us the stones, send a rain of stones upon us from the sky. And if it doesn't come, then we will know that this man is making up these stories. This is not a true book or not a true Quran. So these are the kind of things they were challenging. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy is that upon Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was forced to leave Makkah. And in the past, whenever any messenger was forced to leave the town or the city, or even when they threatened him, the azab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came upon them. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam left Makkah. He stayed in Medina. It was mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that after that, the azab of Allah did not come upon the people of Makkah. They were still lucky to live there for a few more years until the Muslims invaded from Medina and Makkah lost and Makkah fell. So this was the only minor punishment that was given to them. They lost the city over in the hands of the Muslims, but they did not suffer a punishment like the punishment came upon the people of the older days. So here we will stop, inshallah. We will continue in next tomorrow, juz number 10. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to understand the Quran and act upon it. Sadaqallahul Azim.